From Montana's news leader, this is the MTN 530 News.
Good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Janelle Slade. Well, tonight, Montana authorities have captured a man wanted in connection with a Shepherd shooting in August. 32-year-old Brian Pretty Weasel taken into custody in a Butte fast food drive-thru about a month after fleeing police here in Billings. Now, Pretty Weasel and another suspect led police on a chase that shut down the Billings Heights for 6 hours. 29-year-old Talon Fritzler was apprehended the day of the chase and arrested on a previous warrant. The two were fleeing from what police said was the shooting of a man in Shepherd on August 6th. A homeowner was shot after he noticed two men trying to steal an ATV. Now, the U.S. Marshals and the Butte Silver Bow County Sheriff helped assist in Pretty Weasel's arrest after Pretty Weasel allegedly backed into another car at the Taco John's in Butte. Well, a mix of COVID-19, drugs, and domestic violence now adding up to a huge increase in violent crime across Billings and Yellowstone County. Today, city, county, state, and federal law enforcement came together here in Billings to release the damaging data. Yellowstone County has had 67 more murders, robberies, and aggravated assaults this year from March through July than for the same period last year. Now, those crimes include 8 murders, along with numerous non-fatal shootings and stabbings. Now, in a combined effort, authorities announced COVID-19 is not going to prevent the prosecution of drug dealers and domestic abusers to the fullest extent of the law. A new report shows since March, meth urinalysis tests in Montana have increased almost 34%, the nationwide increase at almost 20%. U.S. Attorney Kurt Almy says meth supply is down, so there's now a different economic dynamic on the street.
Meth supply is down, and the reason for that is because precursor chemicals from China have been disrupted in their transportation to the cartels in Mexico. And also with the changes in the southern border brought on by COVID, we're seeing disruptions in distribution into the United States. And that has reduced the supply of meth and increased the price to approximately double. By the same token, we know that meth use is up. And that's creating, as you can imagine, a price increase. That's contributing to some of the issues that we're seeing on the street.
Now, the jump in violent crime is also adding major stresses on law enforcement as a whole, but Sheriff Mike Linder says the county jail may be crowded, but, quote, we will always make room for those who belong in jail. State health authorities report 93 additional cases of active coronavirus today. Yellowstone and Flathead counties with the highest numbers, each with 12 new cases. 106 Montanans have died due to COVID complications. The Wyoming Department of Health confirms 4 more coronavirus deaths among Wyoming residents, 1 in June, 2 in July, and 1 in late August. Now, the delay in reporting is because they all died outside their counties. In fact, 3 of those patients died in other states. As of today, Wyoming reports 41 coronavirus-related deaths. In Hardin, school administrators are walking back a 2-week sports season interruption. Now, the district will now allow middle school and high school volleyball, cross country, and golf to resume practice today and tomorrow, but keep football and cheerleading on temporary suspension until September 11th. Now, that date marks 2 weeks after multiple Hardin students tested positive for COVID-19. A press release states that the Hardin superintendent, activities office, and school nurse made the decision to continue the break for football and cheerleading. Well, traveling is a Labor Day favorite, but that, like everything else, is a little more difficult this year. Just 1 week after being taken off New York's quarantine, Montana is now back on the mandatory travel advisory list. Any Montanan visiting New York or New Jersey or Connecticut must self-quarantine for 14 days upon arrival. Any state with more than 10% positive coronavirus rate or a positive test rating higher than 10 per 100,000 residents qualifies for that list. So far, there are 30 states on the list. Well, travel restrictions also remain in place at all Canadian international border crossings, and that means no United States citizen is allowed to enter Canada for any discretionary or optional travel. Those restrictions remain in place until at least September 21st. Well, now turning to Chief Forecaster Bob McGuire, with high heat also comes an increase of fire danger, Bob.
Yeah, we were afraid this is going to happen again. Let me show you what's happening all across eastern Montana, from the mountains all the way to the Dakotas. We have a red flag warning that started today at noon and goes all the way through to midnight tomorrow night for eastern and south central Montana. Around the mountains, it goes to about 6 p.m. tomorrow night. But I tell you what's happening is we have high wind, low humidity, and increasing temperatures. That's perfect for making erratic fire behavior, possibly even some new possible fire starts. So how much more heat are we going to get? Remember, today we're only into the low 80s right now, but tomorrow, bam, we're topping up to 94 degrees, cooling back down to the 85 on Thursday with a new cold front moving through. That's part of the reason we have the fire, the red flag warning, because we're looking at some gusty winds around the cold front as it moves through. We'll have the rest of your forecast in a few more minutes.
All right, thanks so much, Bob. Well, the Environmental Protection Agency is now proposing to add a large swath of land near downtown Billings to its national priority list for Superfund cleanup. Groundwater has been contaminated by dry cleaning chemicals and other industrial sources on the 855-acre site, which originated on the Big Sky Linen property in the 700 block of Central Avenue. The issue extends about 3 miles in a mixed-use area. Testing shows some of the contaminants known as PCEs have moved from groundwater through the soil and entered some overlying structures, a process called vapor intrusion. Billings Mayor Bill Cole says adding this land to the national priority list will make it easier to access federal dollars for monitoring and mitigation. The proposed listing will be subject to a 60-day public review and comment period beginning September 3rd. Well, Montana Democratic candidate for governor Mike Cooney stopped in Great Falls today to unveil what he calls his Growing Montana plan. MTN's Matt Hausoffel tells us what Cooney says are the key points leading up to the November election.
Lieutenant Governor Cooney was joined by U.S. Senator John Tester to present his Growing Montana plan, a plan that Cooney says will support working families and small businesses throughout the state. He also added his support for the Affordable Care Act, the hemp industry, and said that the agriculture industry is the most important sector of Montana's economy.
They want to work. They don't want a handout. They want to work. They want to produce. And we're going to make sure that they have the tools to be able to do that.
In front of a small crowd in Gibson Park, Senator Tester called Cooney a friend to agriculture in Montana before handing him the stage. Cooney introduced his plan, highlighted by increasing funding for the Growth Through Agriculture program and reinstatement of country of origin labeling for beef and pork products.
When the agricultural economy suffers, Montana's economy suffers.
The lieutenant governor also expressed his support for locally sourced meat and addressed bringing slaughterhouses and feedlots to the Treasure State.
You know, we have some good production in Montana now, but they need to grow. They may need some additional capital, and we need to address some of the rules that they have to operate under.
He ended the event with comments regarding the country's trade war with China and how it has impacted Montana's farmers and ranchers.
The trade war has been, I think, devastating on our local agricultural producers. It's done away with markets. It's kept prices low. It has caused prices to be high on things that they need to buy.
Cooney continues to ramp up his campaign efforts ahead of the November 3rd election. That pits him and running mate Casey Schreiner against Republican Greg Gianforte and his running mate Kristen Juris in their bid to replace Steve Bullock as governor of Montana. In Great Falls, Matt Holzapfel, MTN News.
Thanks, Matt. Now, Cooney says the need for extra support for Montana's farmers and ranchers goes further back than just the start of the pandemic. Well, up next on tonight's Q2 530 News, if you know someone or you possibly have tested positive for COVID-19, there are some potential lingering symptoms to know about. And in sports, meet Q2's Athlete of the Week, the first Red Lodge player this century to commit to a Division I program.